Now we're going to go through a process for installing Main Street electrical parade lighting on your Main Street. If you've been to my website, you've seen the original way I did it, which turned out to be, I think, far too complicated for anyone else to do. And so we've come up with a much simpler way to do this, really the most complicated part of this whole process is making these little LED things, which we'll show you in a few minutes. But it's pretty easy. It does require you to drill holes in your roadway for the lights to come up through. And so that's probably the only scary part, but we've tried to make that pretty simple for you. As you'll see it in a few minutes. In fact, the simplest part of this is Bob Olszewski positioned all of the floats on the street, including set 5, which at the time we're doing this video doesn't exist yet, and from that I created a template of where the holes would go and where to drill them, and I put that template online on my website, and our first step in this whole process is to go download it. So now you're going to be going to get 5 files from my server and pull them down. They're all going to have more or less the same name. There are 5 templates, MSEP template 1, and then the next one you're going to get is going to be template 2, right? And then you'll get template 3, 4, and 5. So you'll need to go get all 5 of them, and I'll show you how to download them. If you're not a real Windows expert, well, I'm just in the internet browser here, and gonna right-click the window. That's a right mouse click, and there's an icon down here that says Save Picture As, and it's gonna give you a saving browser, and you just choose where you want to save it, and press Save. When you've got it saved on your computer, then you go on to the next step. So here are the 5 files that I downloaded, and you just click on the first one of them, and a big window pops up that has the picture. Now this one is using Photo Gallery, but there's lots of other standard displays. On pretty much all of these, you're going to see that there's going to be a print button on there somewhere, and this one is up here, and you're just going to say print. And now this next step is pretty important. When you're actually doing the printing, the paper size, just say 1/2 by 11 or whatever paper you have loaded, but the important bit is over somewhere on the window you're going to find where you can pick the size of the image to print. And in this case, I've made these templates so that they should all be printed in 8x10 size. Be sure to say 8x10, otherwise the picture is going to come out scaled wrong and you'll have a wacky template and it won't work. I'll give you a check later to make sure you did it right. But when you start off, make sure you print them in 8x10. And somewhere in the screen, it's going to say, give you the option to fit the picture to the frame. Don't do that. Make sure that you don't fit the picture to the frame. Otherwise, it'll change the scaling of the picture again. 8x10, don't fit the picture to the frame, then go ahead and let her print. So now that you've got your 5 template sheets all printed, now it's time to splice them together. Try to make that pretty simple, and I'm going to demonstrate the first 2 sheets here. First off, you'll notice that all the sheets are numbered 1 through 5, and that's the order we're going to assemble them in. First step is take the top of sheet 2, 3, 4, and 5, and where you see the line, which was where the 8x10 print went, just fold the edge of the paper over as close to that line as you can get. Right on it would be perfect. You see a little white is not a huge problem. just fold it over. Should look like that. And then you're going to start to splice it together with the sheet above it. Now if you look, you'll see these two arrows which form an X when the template is properly located. So hopefully you can see that it's forming an X, and that means it's lined up right at that level. The second thing you're going to notice is there's a center line that runs through all the templates. It's important that center line be just pretty much exact. I mean, that one, you really want to make sure it's right. Otherwise, the other pieces won't line up. So, lay a straight edge over that. Lay that down there. Get the X's to line up. There, that's good. All right, so once you got the X's lined up, oops, this one's not quite right. Now take your time with this. Make sure this is lined up right. And just hold it steady for a second. The second check you can make, which I recommend, is to place a ruler on the paper. And you'll notice I have some marks on the 8x10. And it gives you a measurement from here to this X, which should be 8 inches. And turns out it is. And then from here to the bottom X down here, which, let's see if you can see. Yeah, you can see it. And that should be 18 inches. So if you measure those out, you should get the right measurement. And if you get that measurement right and the X's line up, then you are good to go. Just rechecking the thing for straight. Make sure the center line is straight. Good. So with that, now just take a piece of Scotch tape and tape them together. And that's all it takes to reproduce the templates. And you'll repeat this, of course, for the other three panels. And you'll end up with something that looks like. So you're going to end up with something that looks exactly like this, with sheet one spliced together to sheet two, and so on, as you work your way down the template. Now, this is probably a good time for me to talk about what's going on down here in short sheets four and five. At the time that we're doing this video, the set five of floats are in production. They haven't been finished yet. And so Bob Olszewski has given me the prototypes. And with that, we have done our best job of laying out where we think the LEDs are going to end up. And so starting right from where the sheet four dot is, and down this way, that's where the finale floats are supposed to end up. Now, I will revise the templates once set five comes out. And you'll see on the templates that you download whether there are labels on these points or not. Right now there aren't labels because that means it's not in production. But if you download a version and there's labels on these points identifying them, and it'll say this is the production location of set five, then you'll know you're safe. For sure. I mean, we think this is pretty close for now, so I'm going to go ahead and drill and locate LEDs for these, especially since I don't want to be messing with this roadway again. But you might want to wait for that. But starting above this point, you see where Elliot goes, Turtles. I mean, the rest of the floats from there up are for sure, and there's no risk in mounting those at all. Let's see, what else do I want to say? Oh yeah, the top of sheet one, it'll tell you it points towards its turn station. It's pretty obvious. Now let's talk about these center lines again. This center line that I pointed out before, this one is obviously going to run up and down the length of Main Street, right in between the track rails where the trolley goes, and that's going to position the template this way. Now, this top part, this top line here, is going to position the template
and this axis. And you're going to lay this line here directly in the center of the roadway as it passes in front of this drain station. Not next to the tracks, because those are tucked in next to the hub, but or the town square. But you want to make sure it's in the middle of the roadway. I'll show you that next. Okay, so what I've done now is I've taken the roadway. This is the roadway off the platform. And if I put blue painter's tape down, and in all the areas that we're going to drill and mark, and I've made a couple of lines. You probably can't see it on the video, but I've with my fingernail, I've grooved out where the train track goes, where the trolley track goes. And that tells me where the center of the street is. And I just drew a straight line down the length of the tape. So that gives me a line to center against the template. Then on the top, I measured out exactly halfway down the street here. Hopefully you can see that. And made a line this way across that line. So now with those two references, now we can lay out the template. And I might kind of start by getting the top line kind of right, and then line up the center line. Oh, you probably noticed that I've now gone back to the template and punched out these holes with a pen just so I can see through them. So there's those two line marks. And there's that one. So I've got that one lined up, this one lined up, and the top line lined up. So now the template is aligned. And so now we have to tape it down, hopefully without moving it. So I'm just going to run tape around the edges. Got the top taped. Now I'm going to tape the bottom down here. And this will hold the template into position. Be sure to stretch it out a little bit, because sometimes the paper can bunch up a little bit. So now with the template installed, now we just go back and we're going to just mark where all the holes go. And so I'll just go through back through all the holes and mark them all out. There should be 36 of them in all, so I'll be right back after I'm done marking everything. Alright, so now I've finished marking out the template onto the tape, and I've pulled the template off. And if your marks are like mine, they're probably a little hard to see, but this is a good time to go back and just recheck them. And what I'm doing is I'm just darkening up the marks, and the ones that go on the center line are easy. You just have to find the mark and draw in the cross hatch so you can see it, and you can drill it later. Now, for the most part, the exact location of the LED is not important, just as long as it's centered, except for the pieces that have two LEDs in them, like Elliot. So those I just double check against the template to make sure that the marks on the table were right, because those have to be pretty close. Otherwise, we don't really care. You can be off by a quarter of an inch. I don't think no one's going to notice. So we just work our way around the template, double checking their measurements, and these are all coming out really good, so you shouldn't have any trouble with this. And so once you have all these marked, then we go on to drilling the holes. Okay, so now it's the moment of truth. if you're going to change your mind with where you're going to locate pieces, this is the time to do it. You know, there's no science to locating these holes and LEDs, and if you like a different placement of them, go for it. Bob's always super supportive of people trying different things and different layouts and even completely different techniques. But if you're going to do it this way, this is the time to decide. So I've decided where I'm going to lay them out, and so I'm going to start drilling. Now, this is a 13/64 bit, and that I have found to be about the right size for LEDs, and especially with the flanges ground off. And now the only tricky bit about making these holes is that the drill bit wants to move around a little bit as you drill the hole, and so you got to stay very careful to make sure it stays aligned, especially on the straight line area, because if you're off a little bit, you're going to be able to see it. So just keep your eyes open as you make the hole and make sure the bit stays still. And that's all there is to it. You just work your way around and drill the holes in. Keep drilling, and I'll be back when the holes are all drilled out. All right, and now as we go to assemble the LEDs for the electrical parade, I've purchased quite a few of these fast flashing LEDs from eBay. These are 5mm fast flashing LEDs. I'll give you the part number, or at least the description. They're cheap. I mean, you can get 100 of these things for $7. And for another buck, you can get 100 resistors. So that's what I've done. These are 100 ohm resistors, which are the right resistors to use with the fast flashing LEDs with a 5 volt power supply, which is what we're using here. And so we're going to attach the resistors to the LEDs for the installation, and I'm just going to do that simply. I'm going to put the LED in the clip here to hold it, and I'm just going to pull the resistor off the pack. And I'm just going to bend it here kind of towards the base of the resistor. And I'm going to put it on the positive lead of the LED and crimp it into place. Take my soldering iron and solder it into position. Good. So now with it soldered into position, we're going to cut off the excess leads from the LED and from the resistor. Alright, I'll take a pair of needle nose and just bend it all straight. And that's it. That's what it looks like when it's done. Just the LED with the resistor in series with the lead. And so we're going to repeat this. We only need 36, but I'll make a couple of extra, so I'll probably make 40 of them, just so we'll have some extra. And that's all there is to assembling them. Okay, so now that we've got all of our little diodes and resistors attached, now we're just going to put some heat shrink tubing on them so that they'll end up looking like this. And what I've done is I've taken 1/16 inch heat shrink tubing, cut it into 1 inch pieces, and I'm just going to slide it over the resistor here. And then I'm just going to hit it with the heat gun. Shrink it up. For all of these resistors you're making here for the electrical parade, it's not
the exact measurements you make aren't all that important, as long as they're all consistent. And you'll see that when we go to assemble it. It's so long as you made them pretty much all the same, it doesn't really matter what the dimensions are. The only thing which is important is that this resistor is pretty close to the diode, because you only have the depth of the table to work with there. So anyway, go ahead and shrink all these resistors on, and then we'll go on to the next step.
Okay, so here are our little LEDs with the heat shrink tubing attached and the resistor on. Now, these LEDs, as they're made from the factory, have a very, very narrow throw to them. So they're only throwing light in a very narrow column of light above the LED. And that's a problem for the electrical parade floats, because to light up the entire float inside, they depend upon the light to bounce around inside the float. This is true of the Olshewski LEDs too. So what I find works better is if we can diffuse the throw of the light more inside the float, it'll light it up more uniformly. And so we're going to grind the lens off, just like we did for the tree lights. So for the LEDs that we made, just grind them off. And so that's all there is to it. Just they don't have to be super flat. Just grind them off. Make sure you don't go. You make sure you only stop right where the end of the. I'll show you. Make sure you only grind off just the curved part of the dome, because you don't want to go too far down or you hit the electronics. So stop after you get to the curved part, and do that for all of the LEDs, then we'll go on to the next step. Okay, so now we've got the lenses ground off. Now, for the next step, we're going to be mounting these up underneath the roadway. And we want the hole for the LED to be as small as possible, because you don't want to see a bunch of holes in your roadway. And if you notice on the LED, there's a little flange. I don't know if you can see it or not in the video, but there's a little flange around the LED that's actually kind of wide. And so we're going to grind that flange off and make it nice and smooth. When it's done, it's going to look like more like this. That's not a great example. Let me grind this for you, and I'll show you how it ends up looking. There you go. So there it is, ground off. And that's going to enable us to use a much smaller hole and give us a much cleaner look when we're done. So just grind off the flanges, and we'll move to the next step. I'm going to show you what the difference between the LEDs with the lens on and the lens off. here's the fast flashing LED with the lens off. The slow flashing LEDs look the same way. It's throwing a fairly narrow beam straight up, and the LED is about an inch away from my hand. These are 20 degree throw LEDs, very narrow. So really, inside the float, only that part that you see the little circle of light is being directly illuminated by the LED. The rest of the float is only getting illuminated by stray light bouncing around inside the piece, and it doesn't throw light very evenly. So we'll compare that to one of the LEDs that we've modified, and now you'll see that the light is much more diffuse. It throws around inside the float much more uniformly. This LED is the same brightness. It's just throwing the light more uniformly throughout the float, and you'll notice the difference when you see them on the platform for sure. Okay, so let's go on to the next step, which is, oh, by the way, testing the LEDs to make sure they still work after they've been through all this grinding and soldering and stuff. And if we like it, then we're going to clear up the lens. Remember, the lens gets a little bit clouded with all that sawing. And so we just hit it with some
clear nail polish, and that will clean up the surface of the light. And so, you know, just work your way through the LEDs, and after this, believe it or not, she'll be done with modifying and preparing the LEDs for installation. And our next step would be to actually to install these in the platform. Okay.
So all the holes are now drilled out and happy with their locations. That now it's time to start stuffing the LEDs into the holes. This is where you really find out just how different all the roadways are. That the thicknesses of the roadways can vary by a quarter of an inch, sometimes half an inch. I mean, it's amazing how much they vary. This one happens to be the thickest one I've ever seen. It's pretty thick. And so we're going to use pretty much all the leads on these little LEDs to get them connected. So what I do is I just, working from the bottom of the piece, stick the LED through the bottom, and I look for how much of the LED is sticking through the top. And remember, when you look at those LEDs, and you look at them from the side, you can see where their little lighting element is. You'll see two little, looks like aluminum contacts. I'll have the top of those aluminum contacts just barely visible from the top of the piece. So that means that you know, something like, you know, 2.5 millimeters, 2-3 millimeters maybe of the top of the LED are sticking through the top of the table. I'll give you a close-up of this in a second. And so when you get that positioned, then on the back, you bend the leads over, one lead one way, the other lead the other way. I'll show you this in a second too. And now that will establish the position of that LED in that hole. Now realize that every LED is going to have a slightly different height because of the difference in the thickness of the piece as you go around. So let's give you those close-ups.
All right, so that's about how much of the LED is sticking up, and you can just see those active elements of the LED poking up through the surface. And on the back, this is what the leads look like bent over. And when we're done bending the leads, they're going to end up looking like this. Oopsie said, oh, there they are. They're going to end up looking like this. Focus, little camera, you can do it. There we go. Now, so that's what they're going to end up looking like. And we bend the leads like that so that the interconnect wire will hook onto them, and you'll see how that works in a second. But anyway, just bend them like that, drop them in the holes, and they'll be the right height. But remember, there's a unique LED for each hole.
Now that we have the LEDs all bent and in their sockets at the right height, now it's time for us to attach this copper bus wire along all the leads. This one is going to the negative terminal, so it's got white insulation on the far end. But basically, it's just doorbell wire that I've stripped all of the insulation off of, exposing the bare copper. And we're just running this along all of the shorter leads for the negative leads. And then we'll take another one and the red wire and run it, strip all its insulation off, and then run it across all the longer wires. And really, just all you do is just solder them in. Pretty easy. It's pretty important that you get the copper pretty flat as you go to install it. Otherwise, it's going to twist around and be a mess. Otherwise, it should solder in pretty easily. I'll show you what it looks like when it's done. Well, here's what it looks like when it's been soldered, and you can see the red and white wires, which are going to run off to the electrical parade on off switch in the table, and red, of course, being positive, and those work their way. You can see where they've been stripped off with just the bare copper, and you can see where all the LEDs go, and They're just soldered around till you get around over there. And that's the extent of the soldering. And just one more step. All right, so now we just install some of this. I use clear Scotch shipping tape. There you go. And I use that to both hold the wires in place and give them a little bit of insulation, a little bit of protection against shorting. So you just tape these down. And this is what's going to hold the LEDs up into their holes, too. Just push that down real good. Good. And put on the little rubber feet that go underneath. Piece. And we're ready to install them on the table, which we'll show as our last step. All right. One last look at the back. Oh, you can probably hear the music in the background. Let me turn that down. So, we've run the red and the white wires from the two bus bars at the front. Those have just been spliced into the wires that go to the electrical parade lighting under the table. And let's set it in. And there it is. I'll turn the lights off so you can see the LEDs when they're off. See, the nice thing about this installation, I think, is that even when the parade's not installed, the LEDs are not super visible. So I kind of like this approach. And yet the LEDs are up high enough where they're able to illuminate the floats just fine. So anyway, that's the last step of the light installation of the electrical parade. And if you're wondering what these two wires here, these are the A and B lighting cables, and those go into the buildings, which we install next.